been an amazing experience.
To go even crasser than
I
we
love what
before.
I do. I love the people who I work with. I love the product that I make. I'm very, you know, it's cliche, but I'm a little bit blessed to be able to, you know, keep on doing something that I love as much as I do.
And the switch of networks, how important was that for you as a creator?
Well, it's actually been a really great experience because in some ways it's breathed a whole new life to a show. Now, we were always having fun doing American Dad, but having this new format gives us a little bit more freedom in some ways, obviously with some language, but TBS has been really supportive. It's kind of been an experience where you have this, you had these parents who birthed you and but didn't really get you, and then you leave the house and you find the one that you really who loves you and cherishes you. So that's how I kind of feel like with TBS, because they really do appreciate us sending us here, sending us to New York, really promoting the show. So it's been really nice to have that kind of experience.
Well, it really did take so long for you guys to get your own identity outside of Family Guy. So did you ever feel like, not constrained, but you had to be a little more controlled because you weren't the big dog on the block?
Well, we were always, you know, a little bit of that redheaded stepchild syndrome.
Right.
And we just kind of had to accept it. We always felt like, because it was Family Guy, and I love Family Guy, but I did always feel like we had to separate ourselves enough.
Yeah.
So we concentrated on our own, you know, techniques of, you know, using, you know, characters and stories and mostly focusing on that rather than the cutaways. Because in the very beginning, we thought that that's what we should do also, but we quickly realized we have to separate ourselves.
Right.
And, you know, the show has benefited from that, I think. Nobody wants, I mean, Family Guy is Family Guy. Nobody wants another one of that.
We don't need it, yeah.
And I think that in the beginning of the show, people saw the show and said, oh, it's not Family Guy. It took some time for people to realize that we were doing something different.
Yeah.
And since that time, I mean, we're now at our 10th season, so I think that by now, people who have watched the show understand how different we are. People who just don't really give it a chance just assume that it's, you know, more Family Guy.
Yeah, and this time you've been able to get even more voice cast special guests. Is there someone that's like the big get for you?
That I haven't gotten?
Yes.
Oh, good.
That you've been campaigning on a little bit and haven't had a result positive yet?
Scott Grimes has a relationship with Russell Crowe. We've been trying to encourage that to happen. It almost happened once and kind of fell apart. But, you know, mostly I'm just happy anybody who's going to say yes is going to be into it.
Yeah.
I love... I'm trying to think if there's anybody who I would really want. If I could get Prince on the show, that would be great.
That would be awesome.
I would love that.
Yeah.
So if you have any connections,
I wish. Yeah, yeah.
But at the moment, anybody who does the show, I'm just grateful.
Well, with so many fantastic characters, is there one that you wish you could just devote a little bit more time to that you haven't been able to yet? After all these years.
For a while, that was Klaus. But I think that Klaus has now acquired more episodes. I think that we can still give Klaus a few more of his own stories.
Okay.
But mostly I think that we've been hitting...
Pretty balanced.
Pretty balanced.
Yeah.